Krakauer goal scorer is a Ghanaian, but he's doing all he can for Heartland at the moment. Roland Kofi, what a stunning goal he scored in that 2-0 victory that Heartland had got over Giwa FC. You've seen those goals in the Nigeria Professional Football League. Can you also remember that stunner that Amos Giang of Giwa FC scored against Ikorodu United? It was a cracking goal. You also remember that goal that Bobby Clement scored against Abia Warriors. Beautiful goal. That's what the Nigeria Professional Football League is all about. We love scoring goals, and that's it right there. More goals scored in the rescheduled games played today in the Nigeria Professional Football League. Eba Football Club of Aba, they got back to winning ways. They played that game in Newe, right? And then they defeated Shooting Stars by two. In Umuahia, they defeated Shooting Stars by 2-0. Ifa Enuba had a slim 1-0 victory over Nasarawa United. Now, that's the game for today. Akwa United, the promise keepers, they left Uyo, went to Katsina to beat El Kanemi Warriors by 3-1. I'm just saying that they're doing well at the moment, and we will agree that with good coaching now you can actually get some results.
We know where that
comes from. Look at that. We need someone from Warri Wolves to talk to us. The last time Moses Etu was here, he said a lot of promising things about Warri Wolves, but Wiki Torres tore them apart.
Demolition.
I like what we're seeing in the league this season. Already, we've seen just 9 games. Some things have never played up to 9, and we're seeing loads of goals, and we're seeing good competition.
I agree with you totally, Austin. You know, the contrasting thing about today's game, you talked about Warri Wolves. The two players that scored for Enyimba were former Warri Wolves players, Joseph Osadiaye and Abu Aziz. You know, we are in the represented Warri Wolves last season before they left for Enyimba. You know, and I mean, 2-0 for Enyimba, helping them to climb at least gradually up. But for Warri Wolves, you know, you said Moses Etu was here 2 weeks ago. Yeah. We are all together on this set. Mm. And I think a few days ago, they unveiled a new technical advisor, an expatriate coach. But I don't think the inclusion of that man has done any justice to Warri Wolves.
Some would say early days yet.
Yeah, but
it's just show that it's a system, but it's deeply rooted. You need to find out the root cause.
And Akwa United, like you said, Obogepae Austin was in the colors of the 23 team. He scored that goal. Yeah, I watched the game off a rebound, and this young man has been consistent.
Right.
And the chairman said, you know, that young man could inspire the rest of the players. And that's what we'll be talking about. When home-based players get opportunity to play for the national teams, when they come back, the other players want to give in their best. Mm. And that is what we've been talking about.
That's right.
Then for the other games, you know, we just wish that all the teams could do well. Whether you're playing home and away, you give your best and get a good result.
That's right. So that's the update from the Nigeria Professional Football League. I'll get you to talk about the league table to come up now. That victory for Ifa Enuba and Wikitor is just turned things around. And I was struggling to look for MFM on that table, but that's what it is. It's competitive.
Sixth position
at the moment. So MFM, they've dropped to sixth on the table. Enugu Rangers, I said we need to bring Coach Imama to tell us what he's really doing with this team. Their confidence level is just...
And they're already talking about ending the trophy, title drought. You know, I don't know. 17 points after 9 matches. Mm. And I like the way they've started this season. And
a good start is everything.
You know, Austin, last week I mentioned, you know, the finance. You know, I think the GM of the club listened to this program, watched this program. And the following day, I read him, you know, talking about getting private individuals, some fans of the club who are men of men, you know, contributing to the welfare of the players. Mm. And that's the way we go. If you're having a team that is doing so well, you need to motivate them. you know, beating Enyimba. You know, Enyimba beat them last season at Enugu before Rangers went to Aba and drew. But this season, they've been able to beat Enyimba 2-1. So it's a statement
from behind. Yes.
Absolutely. It's a statement of intent that they know what they're doing. And for him, Mama, I think the issue is that Nigerian Football Federation should identify young, competent coaches
and start training
in the league and start investing.
That's right.
You know, we don't need all this big grammar moving around like a baba's chair.
Yeah.
Identify the best in the country, referees, coaches, and invest in them. So that is the way to go.
I mean, remember we said it, that if you know you have quality in your league, the NFF shouldn't say, oh, it's club business. If you have talent in Warri Wolves, invest in that talent.
As long as they are Nigerians.
Come on, I said it this morning on the show that Leicester City, Drinkwater and Vardy, they're already playing for England. England, they will see them as valuable talent that they can use. So they will do all they can to ensure that Leicester keeps them competitive.
Absolutely.
So the NFL has a lot to do.
At the end of the day, Nigeria stands to benefit.
That's right.
If you support your clubs, they will do well on the continent. Mm. You develop more stars. I mean, football is not just about the players. You look at the key actors, coaches, referees, even match commissioners as well. You need to allow everyone improve on how well they can read the game, on how well improve on their knowledge of the game. And like I said yesterday, when you've trained coaches, anytime the NFL wants to sack a coach, we're always scared because it's going to take them 3 months to sack a coach, another 6 months to employ a coach. And it doesn't happen elsewhere that way. But once you have a large pool that you can choose from, once you have trusted hands, I mean, no young graduate now will tell you he wants to go into coaching, and even you will say go. Because you know the environment is just not.
Yeah, no.
But what if a 28? When did Andres Villas-Boas start? What if a 28-year-old wakes up and say, "I can do this.
Yeah,
I have the knowledge. Yeah. I can do this. Yeah. Let me go to maybe NIS and this." And somebody spots the guy and say, "This guy has a football brain. Let us invest in him. Let us get him a coaching job." I mean, you break all these molds,
right,
and a lot of things start to change, and we're all going to benefit from it.
There's a lot we can do, and that's what the league management company, they're doing. They're doing all they can to ensure that the league football in the country is admirable. And that's why if clubs go against the rules and regulations of the league, you will be sanctioned. And Sunshine Stars of Akure, they are in big trouble. They have been fined 5 million naira and a suspended 2 points deduction for hindrance of TV broadcast against 3C. Remember, the general manager of Shooting Stars, Rashid Balogun, was here, and he was giving his own account of the story. Sunshine Stars have come out to apologize that, yes, we know we didn't do right, there's misconduct here and there. The LMC, they're taking charge, and that's what we want. Sunshine Stars also fined 500,000 naira for crowd trouble and another 750,000 naira for security breach. We want good security in the stadium so that I can leave my house, go watch. You can leave with your family, go and watch a game and be safe. That's what it is. Sunshine Stars have also been given 7 working days to identify, apprehend, and prosecute persons and assaulted 3SC officials.
This is the one I have a problem with.
Yeah.
Some of those people that have been fingered in this case are even supposed to be in trouble as we speak.
Yeah.
And those kind of people were still able to go into the stadium and wreak havoc.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, these are known guys. I was talking with the GM of Shooting Stars on phone. I said he knows the guys. That beat him up.
So it should work with the LMC.
Yeah, so these are known guys.
Yeah, that's what it is.
And they should be prosecuted.
I think one of them.
And if they are found culpable, then they should go to jail.
Yeah. I think one of them is supposed to be under a stadium ban itself. And
mentioned their names.
Yeah.
GM mentioned their names.
For the LMC, it's not just Sunshine Stars. GYFC, they are to pay a fine of 100,000 naira for allocating a jersey number to 2 different players of the club. What's going on?
That's laughable.
No, what's going on?
I think it's ridiculous.
Plateau United fined 500,000 naira for failure to ensure adequate security in match day 9 fixture against MFM at the Wang Pang Stadium in Jos. So we say we want good security. If there's no good security, fans won't come out to watch the game. Rangers media officer, you see, so it's not just players and coaches. And if you go to the stadium and you're not of good conduct, you will get into the problem of the LMC. And also, there's a Rangers media officer. First achievement is to pay a fine of 100,000 naira for unruly remarks aimed at bringing the league to disrepute. So we're willing to work with the LMC to ensure that our football is admirable. FC Fine Uba, they've been fined 500,000 naira for the crowd encroachment after the match against Heartland. Heartland also had to pay a fine of 750,000 naira for assaults on match officials. All of this should stop. Heartland goalkeeper Ebele will be banned for 6 matches for an assault on
the owner of FIFA Yamba also was warned. I mean it's a billionaire, he's owner of a club, he should be above board. So the LMC, you know, said he went onto the field to also, you know, get involved. So I mean, if you're an owner of the club, you must show example.
That's right.
And you should not get involved. You
That's
should
right.
try to make peace.
That's yeah. right.
And I think this occurrences are not good enough for our leagues.
Not good.
Everybody involved,
not
players,
good.
Officials, the administrators, must be seen, you know, to be of good conduct.
Yeah. So well done to the league management company. We said it at the start of this season that the league management company needs to be firm and ensure that there's law and order in the league. Let's put some reasons why people should invest in the league and also come out to watch. So that's it. Big ups to the LMC. Let's do more. Yemi, before we go, it's not just in Nigeria that we're seeing sanctions. Valencia, they say, hey, look, Gary Neville, we don't know what we're thinking, but thank you very much. You can now leave.
Well, it didn't come as a surprise. I think it was better as an analyst than a coach. Out of 28 matches, overall, 110. It lasted 4 months. I still don't understand.
Maybe
because he's a friend of the owner.
They actually gave him a 6 month contract, so I think they did him a favor. Out of the 6 months, after 4 months,
it was famous for the statement that he made while he was an analyst, that if he wasn't a team that lost 7-0 to Barcelona, he was going to retire. And his team lost 7, and somebody asked him, is that he wasn't going to quit. But they've made him do it.
I think there's a linkage to our former coach too, who was an analyst.
And then Cecilia warned me this morning not to become a coach.
I think it's very easy to analyze. Yeah. You know, coaching is
watch football with 10 TV
as reality.
You know, at the time he said he had about 10 TV sets in his home,
monitoring
different angles and all those things.
Okay, guys, I think that's it. Thank you so much, Yemi Adebayo, for your time. Wayne Uchiwa Chukwu, thank you so much for coming there. And of course, to you, wherever you are in the world watching sports tonight on Channels TV, it's always fun doing this with you. When we leave here, let's keep talking on Twitter, or Channels_Sports, and on Facebook, or Channels Life is Sports.